السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر، الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله، أشهد أن محمد رسول الله، أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. حي على الصلاة، حي على الصلاة، حي على الفلاح، حي على الفلاح. الله أكبر، الله أكبر، لا إله إلا الله.
إن الحمد لله، نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه، ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. Dear brothers, in today's khutbah, I intend to share some thoughts on the topic of sincerity, ikhlas, which is an essential part of our noble deen. What is ikhlas? It is the intention to please Allah in whatever we do. A believer must be a sincere person in every aspect of his life. Allah has commanded us to be sincere in our deen, which means in our entire life. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Holy Quran, قُلْ إِنَّ صَلَاتِي وَنُسُكِي وَمَحْيَايَ وَمَمَاتِي لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. Say, my prayer, my sacrifice, my life and my death are all for Allah, the Lord of the worlds. There is a hadith about a scholar, a martyr, and a charitable man, the famous hadith, being judged by Allah on the day of judgment. As would be expected, they would be residents of paradise because of their highly virtuous deeds. Instead, they were thrown into the hell fire because their deeds were done with the intention of seeking praise from the people and not with the intention of pleasing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. On the other hand, there is a story of the unvirtuous woman who was rewarded with paradise for giving water to a thirsty dove. What truly got her into paradise? Was it just her simple act? It could have been because the acts of the scholar, the martyr, and the charitable man were far greater in terms of the sacrifices they made. However, they were punished because they wanted praise from the people which they got. They were insincere in their relation with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But the woman who had held the dog did so for Allah's sake only. Look how sincerity of intention elevates a person's deeds. This is why the scholars have said that ikhlas or sincerity is the most important act of worship of the heart. The driving force of one's acts should always be to seek the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala only. Allah tells us that Iblis promised to lead all the human beings astray except those who were sincere and purified. قَالَ فَبِعِزَّتِكَ لَأُوْوِيَنَّهُمْ أَجْمَعِينَ إِلَّا عِبَادَكَ مِنْهُمُ الْمُخْلَصِينَ Iblis said, by your honor, I will lead all of them astray except for those among them who are your sincere worshippers. My brothers, and we know or told in the story of Yusuf alayhi salam that he was saved from falling into the trap of Aziz's wife, who tried to seduce him because he was sincere and purified. وَلَقَدْ هَمَّتْ بِهِ وَهَمَّ بِهَا لَوْلَا أَرْرَعَى بُرْحَانَ رَبِّهِ كَذَلِكَ لِنَصْرِفَ عَنْهُ السُّوءَ وَالْفَحْشَاءَ إِنَّهُ مِنْ عِبَادِنَا الْمُخْلَصِينَ And she desired him, and he would have desired her had it not been that he saw the proof of his Lord. Thus we ward off evil and indecency from him, for he was one of our servants, sincere and purified. The Quran also tells us about the story of the mother of Maryam having a beautiful private conversation with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, expecting that she would give birth to a male child. She told Allah that she would pledge the child in her womb to his service. And for the sincerity of her intention, even though she gave birth to a female child, Allah accepted that female child to fulfill her mother's pledge. And we know that Maryam alayhi salam, mother of Isa alayhi salam, is among the best women described in the Quran. We learn from the stories of the Sahaba that Khalid ibn Walid radiallahu ta'ala anhu was removed from his post as a commander of the Muslim army by Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu. My brothers, this was not done to humiliate Khalid ibn al-Walid in any way. This was done to let the Muslims realize that it was not because of Khalid's bravery and military leadership that they won every battle under his command, but it was basically because of Allah's favor upon them. After being demoted, instead of being offended and refusing to fight, Khalid ibn al-Walid fought with even more vigor. When he was asked the reason for this, he said, I fight for Allah, not for Umar. Even a small deed done with sincerity is extremely valuable, my dear brothers. Once Mu'adh ibn Jabal radiallahu ta'ala anhu asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam for an advice, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to him, أخلص دينك يكفك الخليل. Be sincere in your deen. Even a small deed will be enough for you. Only Allah knows the sincerity of a person. That's why some scholars say that ikhlas or sincerity is a secret between the human being and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Even the angels don't write it, because they don't know it. Reflective of this, is the story of martyr, the scholar, and the charitable man that was mentioned before. The angels had written down their good acts, but it was Allah who exposed their intention behind those acts. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قُلْ إِنِّي أُمِرْتُ أَنْ أَعْبُدَ اللَّهَ مُخْلِصًا لَهُ الدِّينِ. Say, I have been commanded to worship Allah with sincere devotion. My brothers, do we ever ask ourselves how sincere we are in our devotion to Allah? What does sincere devotion mean? And how can we determine our level of sincerity towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? My brothers, one way is to look within and examine our emotions and our sense of closeness to Allah. Consider the following scenarios, all of which should raise a question. A Muslim says, as you know, I love Allah, but does not pray. A Muslim says, I love the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, but is reluctant to follow the Sunnah or the Prophet's way. A Muslim says, O Allah, I repent, but then defiantly persist in his disobedience. A Muslim tells his spouse, I love you, but then neglects her emotionally or abuses her physically. In all of these situations, there is no connection between the intention and the action. My brothers, a beautiful advice from our beloved Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was, ittaqillaha haythu ma kunta. Have taqwa of Allah wherever you are. Taqwa, besides its meaning of righteousness and piety and saving oneself from harm, also means to be conscious and mindful of Allah. When we are truly conscious of Allah, we will avoid actions that are displeasing to Him. One of the great scholars by the name of Ismail ibn al-Husayn al-Jurjani provided an excellent benchmark for ikhlas, sincerity. When he said, ikhlas, sincerity is when you don't ask anyone to witness your work except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. MashaAllah. We should all try to meet this standard. Thus, when we perform any good deed or engage in an act of worship, let us ask ourselves, are we truly focused on our worship? Are we truly focused on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Are we doing this deed for Allah only? Are we indifferent to what others might think? We can pursue a variety of paths in order to boost our ikhlas to higher levels. Firstly, we should remember that perfection belongs only to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As humans, we make mistakes, but we shouldn't let this discourage us. Allah tells us through a hadith Qudsi, He says, if you take one step towards me, I take 10 steps towards you. Secondly, we should strive to be consistent in all our actions. Thirdly, my brothers, we should equip ourselves with self-knowledge of both our shortcomings and our deficiencies. If we don't know our own faults, how can we improve? My brothers, fourthly, we should endure to be as trustworthy as we can with our fellow human beings by fulfilling all of our obligations at work, home, and in the community. When we build trust with our fellow human beings, we build trust with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as well. Fifth, we should examine our current relationship and search for ways to improve upon them. Have we deceived someone in the past? Is there someone we need to apologize to? No matter how much time has passed, it is never too late to improve a relationship. There may be other paths as well to boosting our sincerity. My brothers, sincerity requires right intention and right action, whether the action is done in private or in public. However, we must also keep in mind that not everything done with right intention is acceptable in Islam. It must be based on right actions as well. Only lawful, truthful, and moral actions are good when done with the sincerity of heart. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq to do so. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين فاستغفروا إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. إن الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه وصلي وسلم على نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم تسليما كثيرا كثيرا. My dear brothers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. O you who believe, be conscious of Allah and speak the right words. He will put your actions right for you and forgive you your wrong deeds. My brothers, the results of sincerity is inner peace, stress-free life, good character, and God consciousness. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us among those people who strive to be among the sincere ones. Ameen. Inna Allahu malaikatahu yusalluna 'alan nabiyyi ya ayyuhalladhina amanu sallu 'alayhi wa sallimu taslima. Allahumma salli 'ala Muhammadin wa 'ala ali Muhammadin kama sallaita 'ala Ibrahim wa 'ala ali Ibrahim innaka Hamidum Majid. Allahumma barik 'ala Muhammadin wa 'ala ali Muhammadin kama barakta 'ala Ibrahim wa 'ala ali Ibrahim innaka Hamidum Majid. Wa salli 'ala jami'il anbiya'i wal mursalin wa 'ala al malaikati al muqarrabin wa 'ala al khulafa'i ar rashidin wa 'ala al sahabati kullihim ajma'in wa 'ala man tabi'ahum bi ihsan ila yawmiddin. رضوان الله تعالى عليهم اجمعين. عباد الله اوصيكم واياي بتقوى الله رحمني ورحمكم الله. ان الله يامر بالعدل والاحسان وايتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله يذكركم وادعوه يستجب لكم ولذكر الله تعالى اعلى واولى وجل واتم واهم واكبر.
الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح. قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة. الله أكبر الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله.
الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا آمين. ألم نشرح لك صدرك ووضعنا عنك وزرك الذي أنقض ظهرك ورفعنا لك ذكرك فإن مع العسر يسرا إن مع العسر يسرا فإذا فرغت فانصب وإلى ربك فارغب. الله سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر.